Generative Fill in Photoshop is a game changer in photo editing, although it's still in beta version. We can forget about content error fill, and in many cases we can use it instead of the clone stamp tool to remove disturbing details. But how does it work with 360 photos? Let me show you how you can use it when it comes to editing spherical panels. Of course, it will work with traditional images too, but I'll share some specific tricks to speed up your 360 photo editing process. I'll show you how to fix Nadir even in impossible cases, remove any objects easier than ever, modify existing objects or add brand new objects to your scene, and how to do spectacular staging for your virtual tours even in an empty location using AI. Let's start with Nadir correction even in impossible cases, when your shadows are crossing the edge of the image or there are not enough samples to use Content Aware Fill or the Clone Stamp tool. In the first case, you can see that we have a very busy ground pattern with a long shadow. If we take a look at this photo in a flat mode, you can see that the shadow of the monopod is cut by the edge of the image, and if we try to fix it with any fill, it won't work perfectly. So here comes my first tip for 360 photo editing. Turn on 3D mode. Fortunately, Generative Fill works in 3D mode too, so as a first step, I turn my image to 360 view. I select 3D, spherical panorama, a new panorama layer from selected layers. I turn the camera down and try to find a view where all the parts which need to be corrected are in frame. Then I draw a rough mask around the tripod legs and the shadow. And here comes the magic. In Photoshop Beta, you'll see a brand new contextual taskbar with a generative fill option. Just click on it and click on Generate. It doesn't matter how big your photo or your selection is, it always takes almost the same amount of time for the AI to analyze and generate fill. And every time it will give you 3 different options to choose from. In this case, I'll keep the first one. And that's another tip for 360 photo editing. After each step, when you have the perfect result, always merge down the generated layers. If you leave your generation on a separate layer, it will move out from its place as you look around in 360 by dragging the background, so it's crucial to click on Merge Down after each step. Besides fixing Nadir with complicated patterns, Generative Fill can be super useful in such cases when we don't have enough space to take samples from. For instance, when we have a very big Nadir patch, just like when I shoot with my motorized panel head. Let's check it out. As you can see, this myops capsule covers a very big part of the nadir, and we don't have enough room around it to get samples for a traditional content aware fill or clone stamp tool. So let's try to select it and fix it with generative fill. I click on generate and select one of these three options again. It's so fast and easy. But of course we can remove further objects or people too, anywhere in the 360 space. In this case, I just simply remove this well here. As you can see, the ground pattern is very complicated, and even more, there's a big umbrella in the background. But I make sure to select the shadow too and click on Generate. And the second option looks perfect for me, so I keep it. And before going any further, I click on Merge Down. Then if I click on spherical map on the bottom, the flat 360 image will open in a new window. Here you can see that the nadir correction is done, and now that well is also removed from the image. But generative fill is more than a smart remover tool. Actually, we can use it to modify things or add something new to our 360 photos. Let me show you how. First, I focus on the leafless trees and see what if I say I want nice green leaves on them. Using this tool, the shape of the selection matters a lot, so I draw the outlines of the foliage. And then this time I give some prompts to the AI so it will know what I'm thinking about. I type in trees with green leaves and click on generate. I get three versions of it, and this time I choose the third one, and of course I merge it down. Then I turn the virtual camera a little bit and continue the same process with further trees. After merging down the generations, I can see all the changes on the flat photo too, and fortunately it doesn't matter if it generates something crossing the edge. It looks perfect in 360, and of course we can check it in this flat view too. It's just the same as with the nadir correction. So I just keep on editing all the trees in the panel. And talking about modifying objects, let's see what if I change these lanterns with something else. Or change these umbrellas with further street objects. Only your imagination can set the limit. But besides removing or modifying anything, we can even add objects to the photo with the correct perspective. Don't forget that the shape of the selection will affect the result in such a case too. I select a bigger area to add some grass. I type in the keywords and start generating. Then I add a bench and further objects, and let's look at the reflection. If I generate some water, AI will generate reflections too. And after a short creative process, here you can see this 360 image before and after. And imagine all the possibilities when it comes to virtual tours, shot even with empty rooms. We can add any furniture, architectural solutions, and whatever we want. Let me show you an example redesigning my attic working room. I select a bigger area just to see what happens and add some keywords. Working with AI prompts are very important. The better you can describe your thoughts, the better results you can get. This time I like this setup, which is very similar to my other equipment in the room, so I keep it. Then I add some colorful pillows to this empty sofa, and maybe pimp up these plants in the window. And I just add another window on the other side too. After all, here is before and after in 360. Maybe the biggest and most important change is the perfect nadir correction, but of course some tiny adjustments and added accessories can help us to create better looking virtual tour photos. So as you can see, generative fill can be very helpful and definitely usable with 360 photos too. Maybe there's one more important thing to mention, and it's the fact that you need to have active internet connection during this editing process. I'm not sure why, but maybe these generations are mostly going on in the cloud, or AI is collecting ideas from online databases to generate stuffs. Anyhow, generative fill doesn't work in offline mode. And if you like it, download your own Photoshop beta version from Creative Cloud and start experimenting with it. I'm sure that you'll find it helpful in 360 photo retouching, or even in 360 videos too. And if you like my tips and tricks, please thumbs up, and for further 360 contents and tutorials, subscribe to my channel. See you next time!